allegations have been raised about some of the SARS men whom people claim always attack just anybody they put on the streets. And some people truly have confirmed that this is not always true. What do you have to say about this, sir?
Yes, let me make a statement on this. Now, first of all, you will recall that when I became commissioner of police in this state in September last year, the first thing I did was to establish the Citizens Complaint Hot Center. Why did I do so? I did so because I know that there is no way that we will police a state such as Lagos and we will not have one or two bad eggs in the force who would want to tarnish our image, who would not behave professionally. And the platform that I established, the Citizens Complaint Hot Center, with 10 dedicated lines, is such that you can call in any language you choose, Yoruba, Hausa, Igbo, Pidgin, or English.
Is 0811-3683-077. The sixth one is 0809628-3148. The seventh is 0809628-3173. The eighth one is 0808-9781657. The ninth one is 0812640493. The tenth one is 0801-4268-95. Those are the 10 lines. They are functional. Please make use of them.
Those lines are not even for general complaints. Therefore, they are specific for complaints against police officers. So please, anywhere, what I don't particularly like is social media propaganda. Where you have a genuine complaint, make use of those lines, report it. And if it's serious enough, send in a petition to enable us investigate quickly. What we see these days is we see unconfirmed, unsigned, unauthenticated social media reports that look more like propaganda than actual reports. So I know the reason why I set up that platform. It's because I believe very strongly that for my policing philosophy, my policing strategy of community policing, community safety partnership to work, I need to win back the trust and confidence of Lagosians. All these achievements we are making across Lagos is because the people of Lagos are beginning to repose some confidence in us. And that's why you see information is coming in regularly. And we are making a lot of a lot of breakthroughs, both in the fight against cultism, in the fight against proliferation of small and light arms, in the fight against drugs, and all that. So please, where you get anywhere, not only the SARS personnel, any policeman behaves in your own thinking unprofessionally, make use of those 10 numbers, which are in the social, which are in the public space, and report their conduct and see the action we'll take.
Okay, one more question, sir. I see that so many times when we come here, we still see many criminals being paraded often enough. Are there other measures that are being put in place so that we don't have so many criminal activities in Lagos anymore?
Yes, I must confess that the Lagos State Government is trying a lot in this regard. Now, let us look at some of the activities of the government, both at the state and local government level, that I think it's helping to reduce crime rates. Now, there's this saying that the idle hand is the devil's workshop. The Lagos state government has stepped up empowerment. Empowerment in terms of employment, empowerment in terms of release of soft loans to young entrepreneurs so that they set up their own businesses. Even at the local government level, you can see that they are coming up with conscious policies and they are partnering more now with the communities to do a lot of youth programs to keep the youths busy and off the streets. So these are some of the things that I think is also responsible. And the truth is that if you have a responsible government, a government that provides jobs, a government that takes care of its ensures that the youths are adequately engaged, then the issue of crime rates will go down. And moreover, this state government have been giving the police command a lot of support, not only in terms of logistics, also in terms of advocacy in the fight against drugs, in the fight against proliferation of weapons and all that. These are all the various ingredients that make for crime. So I think the government is trying its bit. On our own parts, the police too, to whom much is given, much is expected. The state government has been assisting us, and we too are reciprocating by ensuring that we are giving the state good policing. Only yesterday, I took delivery of 100 motorcycles, which were donated by His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Lagos State. These motorcycles, I requested for them to be able to put to a total halt incidents of traffic robbery in Lagos. Because we have traffic snares here and there occasioned by developmental projects, which we cannot halt. Roads are being built, bridges are being built, and of course this will cause traffic. And hoodlums at times want to make use of this traffic to cause a traffic robbery. So I requested for these motorcycles, and in fulfillment of his promise, the Executive Governor of Lagos State sent these 100 bikes, which I'm deploying across the state. So there's a very strong synergy between the police and government. And I'm getting a lot of cooperation and support from all institutions, traditional institutions, all groups. And I think I owe this to the policing concept of community policing and community safety partnership. And I hope it continues.
Finally, the welfare of police officers, how do we see to it that many of them are...
I will not go into welfare because it's not... That is for Abuja. That's for Abuja. Welfare is for the IG.